And this was actually a really tricky question. So let's first mark down the answers. And now we can talk about why. So these were the answers. And let's think about why. We have some really interesting behavior over in some of these graphs, and it's nice to think about what's causing that behavior. So let's start with number two. Pretty straightforward. The robot does exactly what we want. It starts off away from the track, then it approaches it, and stays right on the track. That's exactly what we want PID to do, so this is no problem. Number three looks similar to number two, but not quite, because now you can see the line that we're approaching is not actually the track. That's because we're reaching this steady state where the robot's upward drift is being balanced by its downward tendency caused by this term, and though we reach some sort of steady state, it's not the steady state we want, which would be right on the track. The key to understanding number four was realizing that the robot starts by moving upwards. This is the only case where the robot started going up. And what's happening here is the drift is dominating. Since the tau p is equal to zero, there's no initial term that steers the robot towards the goal. And without that, the drift is going to take over. Of course, as we accumulate error, that gets corrected for and we steer down. But eventually we get into this sort of oscillating behavior. The oscillations are not as frequent, however, as they are in case number one. If we think of this differential CTE term as a sort of smoothing term, which damps out these wild oscillations, then we can see how if tau d is equal to zero, we would expect these sort of growing oscillations. And this behavior is characteristic of any PID controller where the differential term is too small.